Hey there, analytics fans. Today, I want to walk you through the process of setting up Google Search Console for your website. I'll briefly explain a few reasons why you want to set it up, and then I'll walk you through the steps one by one so you can see just how easy it is to get started and connect your website with Google Search Console. Just real quickly, a few reasons why you want to set up Google Search Console. This is essentially your way of telling Google that your website exists, also letting them know what kind of pages are on your site and how Google should handle those different pages on your site, whether they should crawl them, index them, show them in search results, and so forth. You can also do some things with your AMP pages if you are using Google's AMP platform. There's a handful of other small things you can do with Google Search Console. I won't go through all of them right now, but just the last big thing you can do is you can connect your Search Console with your Google Analytics, and then you can actually pull that search data into analytics and do more filtering and segmenting from there. So before we get started, I just want to make sure that I reiterate this. You should have a Google account that is specific to your business. So this should not be a personal Google account. It should be one that you use only for business services. And the Google account that we're going to use for Search Console should be the same one that you're using for Google Analytics. That'll make things so much easier for you to connect those two accounts later. So I'm going to go to google.com and I'm going to go up to the top right and click the sign in button and sign in with that business account. Once you've signed in with your Google account, go ahead and type Search Console in the search bar, and the first result that pops up should be the Google Search Console website. It should be a URL of google.com/webmasters/tools/home, and click on that search result. You will land on this home screen that'll say Welcome to Search Console. You'll have the option to set up either a website or an app. You'll notice in this drop down right here, you have the option for either or. Today I'm going to show you how to set up a website. Go ahead and type your website's domain into the text box next to the website option and click Add a Property. Before you can set up your website with Search Console, Google wants to make sure that you own the site. So you have to prove that you own the domain that you've typed in. There are a few ways that we can do this. The recommended option that Google gives you is to do it via Google Analytics. So if you've already set up your Google Analytics for your website, which I do recommend that you do first, once you've set up Google Analytics, you can go ahead and just click Verify, and Google will check that you have that Google Analytics code on your domain, that it's connected to the same account, the same Google account that you're using, and you'll be all set to go. If, however, for some reason you don't have Google Analytics installed, let's take a look at a few alternate methods we can use. If you're not working with a WordPress site or another CMS, or if you're not using Google Analytics, you may want to upload an HTML file. So if you have FTP access to your website and can upload a simple file, you can choose this method. Google will give you a file to download, and then you will upload that file onto your site. Just make sure that you can access that via your web browser first. Once you can, then go ahead and come back here into your Search Console and click Verify. You can also choose to verify with an HTML tag. That's adding a meta tag to your site's homepage. If you're using WordPress, there are several plugins that give you an option to simply add your meta tag right into the backend admin area. Jetpack is one of them, as well as the Yoast SEO plugin is another one that make it very easy for you to add a meta tag to your site's homepage. I recommend using these plugins if you're using WordPress. The other option you could do, which I do not recommend, is to add the meta tag directly to your header PHP file. The challenge here is that when you change your theme, you'll need to remember to add that meta tag back in to your new theme once you've changed it. You can choose domain name provider. This will actually try to sign into whoever you've purchased your domain with, and it will make a text record in your DNS settings. So you can choose that option if you don't have access to upload a file or you don't want to use the meta tag. You can sign in via your domain name provider. Google will walk you through the steps if you choose this option. The final option is via Google Tag Manager. I don't want to go into details with that. If you guys are using Google Tag Manager, then you should be able to go through that process and set it up that way. But I do highly recommend that you just go ahead and use the Google Analytics method, assuming that you've set up and installed Google Analytics before you've gone through Search Console. Once Google's verified the domain, you'll just see a quick little confirmation message that says you have successfully verified ownership. Go ahead and click Continue. Now there's one thing that I always do anytime I add a new website into Google Search Console, And it's not something that's publicized really well, but I always do it just to make sure that Google knows I own both the www version of my domain as well as the non-www version. So I added the www version of a domain here. So what I now want to do is go in and just add the non-www version to prove to Google that I own both. The way I'm going to do that is I'm going to come up here and click Search Console. You'll see my one website listed right here. I'm going to go ahead and click Add a Property. This time I'm going to add the opposite version of what I just did. So if you already added the www version, now you'll add the version without the www. Go ahead and click the Add button. You have the same methods for domain verification here, so go ahead and choose the same method that you just used in the previous step. Now if you go back up to Search Console and click on that again, that'll take you to your homepage for Search Console. And you should see that you have both your www and your non-www version in your Search Console. What I like to do with all the sites in Search Console that have both a www and a non-w version is that I go to the actual website itself, and however that website is being displayed, it should only be displayed one way or the other. You don't want to have it displayed both ways. So if you have it displayed with the W's, then I'm going to do all of my work here in the Search Console with the domain with the W's. If it's displaying without W's, same thing applies. I'm going to come in here and use the one without the W's in order to make all my changes to and manage everything within Search Console. So just use the version of the domain that appears when you visit the actual site. Once you've clicked on the version of the site that you are going to use to do all of your management, you will see a basic dashboard for that site listed here. That is actually everything that you need to do in order to set up your site with Search Console. So now you do have an account and you can access Google Search Console for your website at any time by coming back here. So once you've set up your Google Search Console account, I'm going to show you one more thing, and that is how to set up a sitemap. I'm going to assume that you already have a sitemap created. This tutorial won't go through the steps on creating a sitemap. I'm just going to show you how to submit that sitemap to Google Search Console. If you're using WordPress, there are several different ways that you can create your sitemap as well as find that URL. So I'll take a brief look at that so you guys know how to grab that URL and then submit it here in your Search Console. So from this home screen, we can click on sitemaps over here on the right-hand side. You can also come over here onto the left-hand side under Crawl and choose Sitemaps. Go ahead and click the red Add Test Sitemap button in the top right corner. You'll be asked for the URL of your sitemap. So let me go ahead and show you one way to find that in WordPress if you're using the Yoast SEO plugin. The Yoast SEO plugin is one of the best plugins for SEO that you can find on WordPress. It is the one that I recommend that I install on all the sites that I work on. And in that Yoast SEO plugin, if you come on the left-hand side in your navigation under SEO, you'll see an option for XML sitemaps. Once you've clicked on that XML sitemaps link, you will see a screen that looks similar to this. Right here, it says you can find your XML sitemap here. So go ahead and click on that link. What that will do is open up your actual sitemap. So here is the sitemap. What you want to do is after your domain name, you want to grab the part of the URL that should say sitemap_index.xml. And we want to copy that, and we're going to paste that back into our Google Search Console. And then go ahead and click Submit. Then we can refresh the page. And here we see the sitemap that we just submitted. So right now, February 22nd is the date that we submitted it. Google will let us know if they find any errors in this sitemap. They could be syntax errors, or they could be pages that we're telling Google about that Google can't access. So it'll just give us more information on how Google sees our site and if there's anything we need to do in order to show up in Google search results. I'll do a more in-depth tutorial later on all the different things you can do with Google Search Console, but that is the basics on how to get it set up and how to add your sitemap so that Google can start indexing your website and all of your pages and displaying you in search results. As always, if you guys have any questions, please leave them in the comments and I will try to help you out. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, you might also like one of these related videos below. And if you found it helpful, consider subscribing to our channel. Or check out our website at wpsmackdown.com for written tutorials and guides.